Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to walk you through how to create your report in Power BI Report Server. Basically, we have installed the Power BI Report Server. We have also installed Power BI Desktop. The next step is to start creating the reports. That's what we are going to see as part of this video. Let's begin. This channel contains free content worth $1,250 or 100,000 INR. Use this free content that covers Power BI, MS BI, and SQL Server. Let's jump into today's topic. So I'm in Power BI Desktop for Report Server. So it takes a while, that's why I launched it. Double click on it, that will prompt you to open this one. So first things first, this is not meant for very new people, those who are creating the report. For them, just go through my Power BI complete playlist where you will understand how you can navigate. I will explain each and every tabs, everything. This is for someone who are already familiar with Power BI Desktop and they want to know about Power BI Report Server. So I will do the things quicker, keeping in mind like those who are viewing this video, we already have idea about Power BI. So let's get the data first. SQL Server, and then I can put my local server dot, and then I can click on the database. So database, I'm going to connect from AdventureWorks, that is for data warehouse. I will click on it and I will use fact sales. And those who are not having this AdventureWorks, no need to worry, you can just use any of the Excel you can create on your own, right? Select related tables as well. I selected all the related tables of this particular table. Let's not go for internet sales reason. I connected only a few dimensions. Let's try to load it. So once you load it, your model is ready and your data will be available. You can start creating the report. So let it launch. The data will be very quicker because it's a sample database, so it won't take much time. Let's wait for a few more seconds. There you go. So it is as quick as possible. So let's try to save this file. Control save, Power BI Report Server, first dashboard. There is no dashboard concept, but I'm just saying dashboard. People often confuse with dashboard with reports, but this is the report, okay? That's fine. So first things first. So once we imported all the data appear over here, we have a data tab where you can see the actual data loaded in the table. Then there is a modeling tab as well. We will have a quick look at it. Everything is good, all is well. So it's based on the due date. So basically it's a role-playing dimension. Let's get rid of inactive relationship and we will create based on the sale date. That is the only thing I need to do the changes. So there are multiple relationship here. The date dimension is connected to different dates. I want only the order date right now. So to understand why, what is this inactive, all those things, you can just go through my complete playlist. Let's have a quick reports over here. Let's try to build it. We already know how to create these reports. Just use the card and we will say, we will go for sales amount. This is my sales amount and I will use the bar chart. I need the sales amount and I need it to viewed by different dimension, which is nothing but my sales territory group, country. That's fine. So all is good. Let's try to copy this and keep other charts over here. Let's view this by year instead of my actual full date alternate key. Okay, all good here. Let's try to change the color, then we will try to publish it. So I hope these things are familiar for those who already worked on this report. I'm just doing my stuff. Those who are very first time watching this video, I'm just changing the background color right now so that it will look a little better. So you can also see what are the features available here, right? So shadow, and here should be shadow. So this will create some good look. So let me copy and use the quantity as well along with the cells. So in order to fill this page, order quantity. There you go. Okay, this is a simple report, and we can name it as a summary. All other features are same. You can have a drill down. You can see a right click and drill down feature is there. You can have a tooltips, dynamic tooltips, bookmarks, and you also have a drill through reports. Most of the core features, these are the core analytical features which are available. As I said before in my previous video, some of the features like mini-tyranny relationship won't be available. You can see this is not available. And even you built reports using some charts like R or Python, the charts will be appearing in the desktop only. Once you publish it, it will not be appearing. So this is all about your desktop reports. It is same like how you create in your Power BI desktop for cloud. So I hope more or less same. We are done with our first dashboard. Let's try to publish it, these reports, in our next video.